talking to him.
But Tim, if he shows up.
There's two more beside that.
Good morning, everyone. It's going to get started for the May 4th TRC meeting. Thanks for coming this morning. We have eight items on our agenda, so we'll get to those as quickly as we can. As we go forward, if you would come and introduce yourself and who you're representing for the projects, and say it very clearly so we have it for the record. With that, we're going to get started. First item on our agenda is to approve the minutes. Has everybody had a chance to look at the minutes? Is there a motion?
Motion to approve.
Motion by Mac. Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Sam. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. Motion carries. Minutes are approved. All right. First item on our agenda is the Seacroft subdivision. Rita, you want to give us a brief overview of this?
Yes. This is a minor development requesting five single family lots. This project that we've been on four TRCs previously, and we still have a lot of outstanding comments. I'll recommend just go ahead and table this project.
Okay. All right. Motion to table by Rita. Is there a second? Second by Matt. All in favor say aye. Opposed, like sign. Items table. We're going to skip number two and put that at the end. So let's move down to number three, which is Carson Oaks, second edition. I believe, Kristen, this is your project?
Yeah, that's correct. This is a plat submitted by Emerald Coast Associates, and it's really to replat lots one and two of Carson Oaks first edition. And the recommendation is to approve the replat. There are really no outstanding issues.
Okay. Anybody have any questions or comments for Kristen on Carson Oaks second edition? Anybody from the TRC have any questions or comments?
Is this one where recreation fees previously been paid?
Yes. Yeah, we did check that. Everything's paid, and they're just moving a middle line. I had a minor comment about a setback that he could actually get some more space if he wanted. I'm not sure if they're going to revise, but other than that, it was good.
Any more questions for Kristen? All right. Who's here? He's here on behalf of Daryl. Good morning.
Good morning. I'm Daryl Burgess with Emerald Coast Associates. The objective is to move the common lot line to better accommodate a couple floor plans the client desires. There was one comment with engineering about clarifying the name of the owner's association. I'm going to start looking those up for myself. I'll be relying on my client there. Try to avoid that in the future. And the setback, I'll even run that past my client again to make sure he wants to show a 10-foot versus 7.5. But if I'll even email you directly on that one.
Okay.
Those are the only issues that I'm aware of.
Great.
Okay. All right. Thank you, Daryl. Anybody from the public have any questions or comments on number three, Carson Oaks, second edition? Anybody from the public? All right. Seeing none, what's the wishes of the TRC?
She made a recommendation.
Okay, all right. Motion by Kristen. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Second by Renee. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. Motion carries. All right. Brings us, let's go back, because Tim is here now. Let's go back to number two that we had skipped previously. Bridgewalk Subdivision Plat. Tim?
This is a plat application by JP Engineering requesting approval. About 74 residential lots and 19.48 acres of each land use of small manager. This item was continued from the last year. Because they weren't here, I guess they're not here today, but I met with them to go over the comments, so I don't see any issues with it. They have not been submitted.
Okay.
We met, went over the comments,
Your name, sir?
Tracy Jernigan with JP Engineering.
Okay. Tracy, any comments or questions? Okay. All right, anybody have any questions for Tracy from the TRC? Any from the public have any questions or comments on number two, Ridgewalk, 7 flat? All right, seeing none.
I'll make a motion to approve it pending resolution of all outstanding issues slash comments and move it forward to the Board of County Commissioners.
Okay, motion by...
Once we have a signed by...
All right, motion by Tim Brown, is there a second?
Second.
Second by Matt Carpenter, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. Motion carries. Thank you, Tracy. All right, moving down to number four on the agenda, the Koch Center Multipurpose Building.
This is a minor development application submitted by JP Engineering requesting approval to construct a 2,100 square foot multipurpose building on 7.8 acres with the future land use of estate residential. This is the Koch Center property adjacent to the hospital. Planning was the only one that had comments on this one. It was pretty straightforward. They're mostly clarification.
Okay. Tracy, any questions or comments about those?
No, just briefly, this was this is a project. It's a campus that has facilities for the psychiatric evaluation. They were impacted by the eminent domain taking by 331, so what they're trying to do is combine revising the driveways to connect to the new DOT driveway connections, as well as this multi-purpose building. If it's not a traffic generator, it's basically for in-campus use only, for an indoor activity center for the residents there.
So okay.
Pretty straightforward.
Thank you, Tracy.
One of the issues was code requires a 5-foot sidewalk on 331, but it's a rural section, so they could ask the director to waive the requirement.
Yeah, if we just get in writing, we'll evaluate that. We'll have to wait this out. All right, you back in the public have any questions or comments on number four, Koch Center Multipurpose Building? You back in the public. Right, seeing none.
Okay, I'll make a motion to approve the project pending resolution of all outstanding issues slash comments.
Okay, motion by Tim Brown, is there a second?
I'll second.
Second by Matt Carpenter. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. Motion carries.
Thank you.
All right, number five on our agenda is Prominence Phase 3 North Platte. Renee?
This is a plat application submitted by Interlight Engineering requesting to plat 75 triplex units with future land use of traditional neighborhood. This project's within the Prominence PUD DRI. And we have a few outstanding zoning comments. One of my concerns is the acreage and if we're incorporating anything else, because there was a mark there on the survey that said 6 acres when it was, the development order was 5.6 acres, so that was a concern they need to match. We will have fees that will be required to be paid as part of the cladding. It's a proportional fair share, 911 addressing, and proof that preservation buyout fees was paid for the development order. Any other questions?
I don't think so. I think this one's relatively easy.
Okay. And that's the TRC. Any more questions or comments?
Could you say your name for the record?
It's Curtis Smith from Interline Engineering.
Curtis, any more questions? Okay. And make the public any comments or questions on number five, Prominence Phase 3 North Platte. We'll make the public. All right, seeing none, what's the wishes of the TRC?
I'll move this forward once all signatures and fees have been paid to the Board of County Commissioners. And all comments can respond.
Second. Motion by Renee Bradley, second by Tim Brown. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. Motion carries. Number six on our agenda is Prominence Phase 4 North Platte. North.
And it's not a plat, it's a minor development order application requesting to develop 132 triplex lots on 11.37 acres with a future land use traditional neighborhood. The project's in the Prominence DRI PUD.
Okay, any questions or comments?
We do have a few outstanding planning comments. We also have a buyout fee that has to be paid.
PFS required to?
Well, we'll say all the ways and stuff that's kind of cloudy.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think so. David and I looked over this yesterday. I think everything was pretty clear.
We do have a portion of pressure for traffic with them, so as well.
The only thing that we're going to bid, just to clarify, is with fire to talk about the multiple access points. We're not sure where he's coming from on that because there are three access points in this phase.
The subdivision itself, I know you guys have talked about this extensively, so the city will call you to talk some more about it.
Well, the issue of that is we're allowing all these projects to continue to occur with only one access out of the whole subdivision. So now we've got, I don't know how many houses are there now, and we're continuing to add to it. But we've only got one way in and one way out, so that's my concern.
Northside actually has multiple because they had another entrance over. The south side has multiple. Yeah, the north side has just got extra wide, 36 foot or so entrance in it, and it's a DRI and PUD. I don't know that you can do anything to those.
Probably not, but for the record, I think I could. Actually, I
think
I don't agree with it, so
you know,
that's what
he'll be calling you.
Okay.
He wants to keep talking to you.
Thank you, Sam.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Kurt, any more questions or comments?
I think that's it.
Will the Mayfield public any questions or comments on number 6, Prominent Face 4 North? Seeing none, what's the wish of the PRC?
We'll move to us forward to a development order once all comments, including some of these, have been satisfied.
Okay, all right. Much more, Renee. Is there a second?
Second
reading.
Second by reading.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like so. Motion carries. All right. Brings to number 7 on our agenda, Emerald Bay Phase 2A plat. Okay.
This is a plat application submitted by Preble Bush Dewberry, requesting approval to plat 23 single family lots on 4.54 acres. This is within the Emerald Bay DRI. We do have some outstanding comments. Planning and environmental have some fairly significant comments. The one thing that we would like confirmed is that the jurisdictional line on the previous survey is still valid through DEP and Corps of Engineers. We can get that. I think we'll be good without requesting a new environmental assessment. Otherwise, if we can't get that information, we will request an environmental assessment and ask the developer to order be amended accordingly. So at this time, I'm willing to move this project forward based on us getting that information. If we don't get it, then we will be bringing the project back to TRC.
Okay. What's your project,
Bill?
No.
No.
Hey, Malcolm, how are you doing this morning? Good. Did you get all that?
I did. Okay. Malcolm Williams, Purple-ish.
Okay. Good morning, Malcolm.
Good morning.
Any questions or comments about what Renee had mentioned?
No, the specific survey for the environmental was one of the key points to the TRC comments. Mm-hmm. Some of the other comments regarding the boundary survey not matching up with the plat, I need to resolve with you just offline here, basically to decide what we did. It was a final plat produced back in 2004 by Baskerville, but it was never turned in, and so our surveyors have not agreed because you have different companies haven't agreed exactly how the boundary works. So there's a difference of 0.06 or 0.08 in area. And so we need to resolve how that gets put in. But it's not a significant, it's not a change from the original intent. It's just a 5-foot access easement comes in that we include in our boundary, overall boundary survey.
I think one of my largest concerns on that was looking at the actual lot line depths on the back lots that is adjacent to the wetlands to make sure that those lines are the same.
Yes, and I didn't see anything greater than a foot.
I know, that is, they're supposed to match. So that's what we're looking at.
Okay. They straight line these lines around the outside to not have all the jogs in the wetlands. The construction plans don't show any dimensions. They don't really show any real dimensions like a site plan. This final plat does. And it's got accurate dimensions, which is exactly what we produced for our final plat. But the actual construction plans, I didn't find any true dimensions. But you can tell there's a difference in line work.
I have to follow with me, so after the meeting, if you've got a few minutes, I can show you what we're looking at.
Okay.
Okay.
Anything else other than?
Have you got any questions or more? All right.
Kristen, are you good with the motion?
Any from public, any questions or comments on Emerald Bay Phase 2A plat? Anybody from the public? Seeing none, motion to carry.
I will move this project forward, but we will not schedule it to a BCC meeting for final approval till we get all signatures on the Mylar and all of our mail comments and other comments have been met.
Okay.
Motion by Renee, is there a second?
Second.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign, motion carries.
Who's second?
I am.
All right, number eight on our agenda is Bayside Ranchettes Parker Park.
This is a county project. It is a minor development order application submitted by Rebel Rich requesting approval of 4 parking spaces, a dock, a pad for picnic table and drinking fountain, feature land use and parks and rec. This is on the back. There has been one comment only by environmental. And that is that there was stormwater on the site plan that was within 50-foot buffer of that, and I think they resolved that by changing that to erosion control. I think it's just a 6-inch depression. Otherwise, everything has been moved out of that 50-foot buffer, and all comments have been satisfied otherwise. So okay. They're going to relabel that. Make a motion to approve to development order stage pending resolving work for one comment.
Okay. Anybody have any questions? The public, any questions on number 8, Bayside Ranchettes Parker Park? Anybody from the public? Okay. Seeing none. You made a motion to recommend approve. Okay.
Commissioner
Vivian.
Okay. I did get a call from the commissioner's office, Commissioner Chapman. Apparently, even though it's a Walton County project, he had not been notified that this was occurring in his district. So I think he's happy, but it was just kind of a surprise that it hadn't happened. I think that TDC, which this is a TDC project, should be responsible for that. And also a call from Commissioner Meadows' office. So there hasn't been any public comments, and they're actually excited about it.
Good. Okay. All right, very good. So motion by Vivian to approve. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Second by Renee. Is there any discussion with anyone? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. Motion carries. And that is it. We're done. Yeah.
Yeah.